read that plan, it clearly demonstrates the number of sectors that we are planning to grow. Obviously, the one that is going to be driving everything more than others is the issue of the infrastructure development. As you understand that from Transnet and from the national department, the national government, there's a huge plan to expand the port, move into the site which we used to use before as an old airport, and the road infrastructure to connect Gauteng as well as KwaZulu-Natal, and the improvement in the rail. That's where most of the jobs are going to be coming from. However, over and above that, you've got all other sectors, especially in the manufacturing sector. We are looking to put up down in the south of Durban, what we call an automotive supply park, meaning that all the companies that are at the moment importing components for the automotive sector, we want to encourage them to come and manufacture from South Africa or from Durban in particular. Mm-hmm. So in that sector, we are seeing a number of jobs going to come from. But moreover, we have the agricultural sector that we believe is a sector that has been undermined for a long time. As you'll agree with me, that sector has a huge potential going forward to create quite a number of jobs. So when we look at it, yes, in government point of view, we are looking for jobs in terms of the expanded public works, but we are not only relying on that. We have a very different plans for each sectors. And the other plan that was defined by the leaders this morning is the hubs that we want to set up in each and every district. So you go into places like Ladysmith, there's going to be a hub there with the government putting up the infrastructure and also inviting the manufacturing sector to come and support. So that is going to be happening 11 times in the province. So we are very confident that we'll be able to create some of the jobs that we mentioned.
Okay, fantastic. Just a final question. We've heard from the Premier, we've heard from the MEC about KZN's ambition to be the focal point and entry point for stimulating trade within the region, the SADC region, and obviously as the natural, making use of its natural advantages, the ports and so on, and the logistics prowess that the province has. From the private sector, however, what sort of investment support does your agency, does the province provide to sort of incentivize these people to come through to the province and to help create those jobs and to stimulate the economy as well?
Yeah, we always try to run away from the usage of the word incentive, because the incentive in South Africa, as you agree with me, is all administrated at the national level within the Department of Trade and Industry. So as a province, we also tap into the funds that are there. However, what we do as a province is to create a platform. Making an example, I'm now talking about the hubs throughout the provinces, but if one were to make an example of the Richards Bay IDZ, that's a platform where the government invests its own money to create an infrastructure. So if you come in as an investor, you come in into a platform where the rail, all the required infrastructure is already in place. So you can either choose to buy and build your own office space or a factory, or you can actually come and lease. That actually helps to cut down on your operational cost. So in fact, as a government, it's a question of building an infrastructure that is conducive. But the other important point really is that when you talk to the private sector, they will tell you that they are not always looking for funds from government. They are just looking for a support. The support that will make processing of their applications quicker and easier. I mean, you talk about the issue of environmental impact assessment. To do that, they will complain that it takes far too long to get it to the final. So the intervention from us as an agency is to assist the companies to move through those processes much quicker than they will normally do, because the time that it takes, if it's too long, it's costly to the business. And at the end of the day, it end up discouraging the very same investors that we are trying to attract. So that's the area of focus going forward.